Hi, I'm Aaliyah. I'm a New York chef who's passionate about exotic spices, traditions, and places. Welcome to my exotic table. A few years back, I took this trip to Acapulco with a girlfriend of mine, and I had what I think was the most memorable meal of my life. The restaurant was set in the mountainside, up on this hill overlooking the ocean, and you could breathe in the salty air as you were tasting the bright Mexican flavors. Going to Tortilleria Nixtamal, my goal was really to learn the historic tradition of corn tortilla making, which is impressive. But it was really Santiago's food, the dishes he taught me, the quesadillas, the salsa verde, that's what brought me back to my trip and inspired this corn and mushroom tortilla salad.
Okay, so this is the salsa verde.
Yeah, the salsa verde.
Okay.
We have jalapenos.
Okay.
Tomatillos, garlic, and onion, and salt and pepper.
Okay. I like the texture. It's like a little bit. You still have the.
Yeah.
Spicy.
Yeah.
It's really spicy. Love to throw this on a taco.
Okay.
Ooh. Look at this. Oh, it stuck to my fingers. Epazote. How do you, some people like it, some people don't like it, right?
This is the,
describe it.
Yeah, it's like between, you know, oregano.
Yeah.
And be mean, just a different.
And it's strong.
It's, yeah.
Strong, but it's nice.
The big ball.
So it is like mozzarella, it's kind of spongy and,
yeah.
And thick.
This is cheese, come from Oaxaca.
Okay. Cheese melts.
Yeah.
You
see?
Yeah.
So when the cheese is melting,
yeah.
So
it's done.
It's done.
It's ready to eat.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for teaching me all these dishes.
Enjoy.
Stands in the summer are an obsession of mine. I lose my mind every time I step into a market and come home with boxes full of produce until my fridge is bursting. Most of the ingredients that we use for Santiago's quesadilla have been staring at me at the markets, particularly the corn, which is just overflowing. Between the farm stands and Santiago, that's what inspired me to come up with this corn and mushroom tortilla salad. And yes, we're using mushrooms, shiitake mushrooms. What we use with Santiago is something called huitlacoche, which is basically a corn fungus, or a mushroom that grows on the corn itself. I'm using shiitakes because they're fresh in the market and they can still replicate that earthy woodsiness that tasted so good in that dish. I'm gonna put a bowl inside of a bowl, and that way when we cut the corn, it will fall all inside the bowl and not all over your countertop. I also like to use a long serrated knife like this one when I'm cutting corn. I just find that it makes it a little bit easier and the sawing motion really gets the kernels off well. Now we're gonna work on these shiitakes, and we only need about 3/4 cup. I'm going to de-stem them and then wipe them carefully with a dry towel. The shallot is the first thing we're going to cook down, and it's going to create some great base of flavor for this dish. Oof. Just chop off the top of this jalapeno. It is strong. Now let's have these beautiful grape tomatoes. I also picked these up at the market, and there's also some really beautiful cherry tomatoes that are multicolored. I saw purple and yellow ones the other day. So the tortilla in the corn and mushroom tortilla salad is actually the bowl we're going to eat the salad in. Tortilla bowl recipes I've seen out there a lot of times deep fry the tortillas before forming them into the bowls, which isn't the healthiest of options. So what I like to do is get a pan really hot, brown up the tortilla, and then add a little oil at the end just for pliability. Two down, two more to go. So the veggies are all prepped, and now we're gonna get to cooking. You just wanna throw the shiitakes in and let them sit for a few seconds. We're gonna brown them up separately just so they develop a really nice color, and we're gonna keep them aside. So the dish would not be complete without fresh chopped cilantro. We got a little bunch here, and I've reserved a few leaves to the side that we're gonna put just on top for a nice pretty garnish. So the dish isn't finished yet. I like to top this with a little cheese. For the quesadillas, we used beautiful, melty Oaxaca cheese. But for something like this, I like to crumble on top. You can use a queso fresco, or I'm using a fresh farmer's cheese, which is also beautiful. Now we're going to use cilantro for garnish. And we are ready to eat. This is such an easy dish to make. It's great for entertaining, and it's a perfect first course. You can prep everything ahead of time and then warm it up right before or just leave it at room temperature. Either way, it's delicious. I can't wait to try it. The flavors are so bright. I can almost smell the salt air. Shauna, Santiago, thank you so much for the inspiration for my exotic table.